This is the application for the Tapo Pan Tilt Home Security Camera. As you can see here, it will list out all of your other Tapo cameras, but keep in mind, just as I mentioned in several videos before, the cameras themselves will only list themselves as Tapo Camera. You will have to go in after the fact and rename them. Keep that in mind, especially if you're doing multiple cameras at once and you don't notice, which is what I did, and then had to unplug them to figure out which one was which. Right here, we have in the upper left-hand corner, it indicates that I have three cameras. Selecting that will allow me to see all of my cameras. Notice they're not currently in live mode. They're merely showing you a snapshot, but we can, from here, set a home mode or an away mode, and that's a quick detection setting that you can do right from here. Now, upper right-hand corner, plus sign, that's how we add more devices, and then next to that, we have the envelope with the red dot, and that's just merely indicating, hey, there's stuff that's been going on. In not my case, there's been a lot of me in the living room downstairs. If you come up here to the notifications area, selecting that will let you know if Tapo has found somebody. Selecting the notification will allow you to take a screenshot, turn on and off the volume, but also, more importantly, download, which will add it to your memories. So if Tapo automatically detects somebody and sends you a notification about it, you can download it rather than having to do the other steps that we'll talk about later. What we're gonna do now is we're going to select our individual camera right here, and then we're gonna give that a chance to load up. And right there, that is a live feed of my living room. You might see a robot vacuum going through there occasionally. Right over here, this grid-like icon, simply tapping that will bring us into a multiple view of our Tapo cameras. Now you'll notice this one, I haven't set one up yet. So let's put one here. If I select that, I can pick any of my Tapo cameras and I'm gonna say, okay. So what we have now are two simultaneous live feeds from my camera. We can also go back to our single mode right here, which will bring it right here. This is our single mode, and then swiping, we can add individual cameras. Again, I'll add my Tapo outdoor right there, and then we can swipe through our individual cameras if we don't want to see them in this overall grid. And I do like the grid in the fact that it is all your cameras, all in one place, all live feed. We're gonna turn that off momentarily because we're gonna talk about what we can do for the pan tilt. To the right of that, we have a icon that looks like a camera that is actually to take a still snapshot of whatever it sees. You've got your record, which will allow you to record a video of exactly what you're looking at. More on that a little later. And then right here, we have our volume control. So camera, microphone. Notice I have that kind of all the way up. We can scale that back and it'll let you know, hey, what's a good zone that this should probably be in? And I'm gonna tap off of that. Here we have the expand. Doing that will, again, automatically throw your camera into full screen mode here, and then you have access to all of your controls right over there. Now you can swipe through your cameras here, but you'll notice that you can't swipe to your grid. You can come down to the right though and select your grid, and then you'll see a live feed of all of your cameras. First icon we have is talk. Selecting this will allow you to talk from the camera. So here we would hold and start talking, and my cats downstairs would hear me if they were paying attention and not trying to get food. Now, one of the things I do like about this is right from here, we can select our settings and we can adjust our camera's microphone as well as our camera speaker right from this location. I do like the fact that that's there. Now, we do have access to our pan tilt controls right here, and then again, set how many degrees the camera will move. So by default, it's set at 10, but you can change it to 5 and 15. That will dramatically change the swivel. Now you'll notice right there, there's a cat. I got a notification that it has detected motion. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna show you, that's the current rotation. Now if I do 15 degrees, just giving you an idea what that looks like, and then down to 5 degrees. So you notice that barely moves at all. So inches, and then we'll go all the way up to max, just to give you an idea. So you really see how much that moves based on individual settings there. Now I'm gonna shrink this back down, because while those were the pan tilt controls, those were the pan tilt controls from the talk location. You might've seen when I come in here, you get more pan tilt controls. So aside from the ability to move the camera left, right, up and down. We have settings here where we can, again, change the degrees, but we also have horizontal cruise, vertical cruise, and mark positions. So what that does is if I select vertical cruise, what that will do is that will cruise the camera lens up and down, and then I can say, wait, stop, I want to stay here. Same thing with horizontal cruise, selecting that will tilt and rotate, and I can tell it stop right there. Now, right here, we have our mark position. So if we want to mark a specific position, we're going to call this position 3. I'm going to save that because the other option right here is marks. So let's say I want to bring it back to my default mark position, meaning, hey, I want to get to something really quick without having to adjust the camera. That's a really weird angle. Well, guess what? Mark position 2 automatically will snap the camera down to a position that I have labeled that is on the XY axis. So again, if I bring it up, that's the one we did for position 3. There we go. Want to bring it down to what I call my main home set, which is right here, position 1. And there we go. It locks it in. The positionings are actually a really cool thing that I haven't seen on a lot of other cameras. And then again, if we wanted to, we can mark a position right here. So we can do it from the pan tilt by selecting mark, or right here from mark. To the right of that, we have our voice call. Voice call is kind of like talking through it, but you've got options where you can speaker on and off, mic on and off, and then hang up the call. It's an interesting feature, not entirely sure what it does differently. Again, we have our mic and audio controls. And then again, we always have access to this pan tilt, no matter what menu we are on. Right here we have our privacy mode. Selecting this will actually turn the camera into privacy mode, meaning that you will not be able to see anything and the camera will not record anything while it is in this mode. The one problem with this mode, with the pan tilt, in my opinion, is the camera lens does not actually rotate itself back. It simply turns off the light on the front saying, hey, I am not recording anything anymore, which is also why you want to make sure that you leave the LED status light on for this so that you always know, hey, it's recording. Right here we have our alarm sound. We can sound that on and off, turn that off. Tapo Care, this is going to be their monthly subscription service. You need to have the subscription only if you want unlimited cloud storage, exclusive AI events, mostly baby crying, rich notifications, which is if you want to receive a notification that is more than just a text saying, hey, you've got something you should be looking at. Custom privacy zones. This is actually an interesting one. We'll get into that a little later. And then motion tracking. This is an important one for your actual camera, because if you've got one that pan tilts, you want this because it will track your person. And then down here you've got monthly and then yearly subscription. We're gonna go back because we're still operating on the 30-day free trial. Right here we have our playback and memory. We'll let that boot up, but we'll go into our playback and memory. Right here, one of the things that I like about the timeline is you'll notice that if I pinch to zoom, it has different colors. These different colors indicate different things. Orange is just a basic movement, while green indicates a person. Now, it is not 100%. As you can see, that is not a person, and I do not end up showing up in this shot at all, but it is pretty decent in that you can rely on it to most of the time tell you if there's a person. Now, if you need to go to a past date, simply select the back button or tap the middle, and everything in blue will let you know, hey, there's something that you can go back and watch. That was our playbacks. Now, our memories over here are anything that we have manually recorded from that front page. Or if we come into our playbacks, one of the biggest things that I have against Tapo and their app here is that, well, guess what? I have all of these events, but there's press and hold. There's no way to actually download that to your phone. You have to record the event so that it ends up in your memories. In fact, we'll do this really quick. I will select, where is this one? We'll do this one because it's a cat. I'm gonna record that. We're gonna watch the cat roll through. Yeah, he's looking for the food. I'm gonna stop that. And what happens now is that gets saved over to our memories, which will then allow us to select and download. It is a really backwards way of downloading something from the phone that it has recorded to the device. I wish they didn't do that. They need to improve that, in my opinion. Right here we have our cloud videos. Again, only if you have the Tapo Care. Selecting that, you will see your cloud videos. And then another place to access Tapo Care. That's everything we can do for the basic navigation and controls of the camera. Now let's come up to our icons up here. Well, we've got our auto. This indicates day-night mode, so I can swap it over to night mode if I manually want to switch it over to night mode. We'll swipe that out of the way, which will then turn on our IR lights and drop the night lens in front. To the right of that, we have our settings or our sprocket right here. This brings us into the configuration settings for the Tapo Pan Tilt. Change the name of our Tapo. It'll give us some other information, network, Wi-Fi, all that fun stuff. Here we have our icon and location select, and that will allow us to change the icon if we want to make this a little easier to differentiate from the other cameras, as well as we can set a home location. Time zone, self-explanatory. Here you can see we have our Tapo free trial. I've got 22 more days of my free trial. We have invert image. So if you happen to be mounting this upside down, this will allow you to actually correct the image so that you can actually see what's going on. Here we have our LED status light. Again, leave that on, especially if you're going to be using privacy mode for whatever reason. Here we have privacy zones. Again, only available with Tapo Care, but if I turn on my privacy zone, what this will allow me to do is set up a privacy zone. So I will add a zone and I will say right over here, couch where I normally hang out. I don't want that to be visible or recorded. I select okay, and right there, it puts a black thing over the couch. Nobody can see, nobody can record. It's a very interesting feature, and it's a shame that they kind of put that behind the Tapo Care or the subscription model, but I can see why they do it. We've got our detections and alerts. Selecting this, we've got motion detection on, and here we have a toggle for on off, the sensitivity, and then if we wanted to set up any active zone. So if I didn't want to grab the entirety of my living room, let's say I just want a specific zone, I can, right there, I only care about that. And I can always add another zone, right there, or that zone, or that zone. You can see, you can have a bunch of these. This is really cool. There are some other cameras that only allow you to have singular, or maybe up to two zones. This one, you saw, I was going nuts. Now we have our AI detection. I have person detection on, and just like you might imagine, it's looking for a person. Don't have baby detection, because, well, don't have a baby in the house to test that with. Now we've got our active notifications. So I've got activity notifications, rich notifications, again, only available with the paid subscription, and then send me notifications when, always, or customize. You can customize everything from a specific time to day. Right here. Here we have our camera alarm. Currently it is off. If I toggle that on, I can select alarm type, lights or sound. So rather than manually triggering, you could have it trigger itself. Alarm, siren or tone, all day or custom schedule, just like you saw before. And then right here we have motion tracking. If I come in and turn motion tracking on, what that will do is actively follow a target. Again, keep in mind this is only available with the subscription for the Pan Tilt. Next we have micro SD card. It's letting me know it's good. I can format it. I can turn off loop recording, which is something nice that they add, and that you can, if you don't want to have the oldest recording overwritten, you can always turn that off, remove the SD card and put a new one in. It's a nice feature. Not a lot of people are going to use it, but it's good that it's there. Micro SD card recording, toggle on and off, as you might imagine. Do you want to? Gotta turn that on. Recording schedule. We can come in here right now, detection recording. I can edit and say, well, here, I want continuous recording. And then you can just swipe, and these are the time blocks that you could do. So to save on space, you can always do selected recordings, or you can record continuously. It's up to you and what you need it for. Here we have our record quality. You got your 3MP. You got your 1080p, and then you got your 720p, which is labeled as data saving, but it still counts as HD. I've been trying out the 3MP, which is the maximum that you can do, and it does get you that type of image that you would expect from that quality. However, again, it's going to use more data on the card and your bandwidth. Here we've got advanced settings. So here we have camera account. You can create an account just to lock this camera. You've got record audio on or off. Some places you can't record audio. You've got on-screen display settings. So right here, do you want to have the date and time? Do you want to have display text? Do you want to have the logo? Display text is nice because, well, you can actually change what that display text says. So if you are working for a company and you want to have the company's name there so you know what it is, you can do that through there. Privacy mode on or off, we talked about that previously. Power line frequency, set it for auto. You have the option for 50 hertz or 60 hertz, but don't mess with that unless you know what you're doing. You've got your diagnostics, and then pan tilt correction. So what this will do is send it back to its default or true center position. And then you've got share the device. They will need their own Tapo account in order to share. Then you have auto reboot. Sometimes you need to reboot your device. I haven't had to, but if you want to set that up on a schedule, you could do that there. And then we can manually reboot the camera or remove the camera from our particular app. Now I'm going to go back one more time to our Tapo main page here for the pan tilt because I want to show you the zoom. Double tapping zooms it in all the way. It's the one thing with Tapo when it comes to utilizing their superior zoom that I really wish they didn't do, because I want to be able to tap tap, bring me in partially, tap tap, bring me in closer. Don't just tap tap and zoom in. I mean, because now I have to reposition. It just seems like it's something that's a little quirky but could be fixed in firmware in the future. Now that's everything that we can do with the Tapo pan tilt. But what we're gonna do is come back to our main page here very briefly to talk about some of the other settings that you have within the Tapo app. We were on our home. That's where we access all of our cameras. We've got smart actions, which will allow you to do specific actions based on, hey, if I'm leaving home, if I arrive at home, am I going to bed? Do I wanna turn something on or off via sunset? You can do all of that from here. You can create shortcuts. You can create automations. You can add stuff up here. Do you want to add a shortcut? Do you want to add an automation? This is very useful with the routines, especially if you're coming home and you want all of your cameras to go into privacy mode so they're not looking at you. This is where you could do that. Now, down here at the bottom to the right of Smart Actions is our account. Right here we can see our camera memory. Selecting that shows us all of our cameras and all of our memories. Here we have our cloud videos. Again, you can select which ones you want, but this is an aggregated area to bring all of that stuff together. Third-party licenses, just like it sounds. Device sharing, if you want to share multiple devices in a singular location, this is how you can do it. Firmware update, it's going to check, do you have any firmware? You don't, that's fine. Notifications, as you might imagine, hey, tell me promotional messages, firmware updates, or micro SD card status. Those are the types of messages that can be pushed to you. Tapo Care, again, this is another place that you can access it. Don't really need to because it's on every other page. Camera preferences, selecting this will allow you to, hey, do you want a live tag? That's what it does with a live tag. Speed tag, right there, shows you the speed. I like that they give you this visual image to let you know exactly what you're looking at. Coming back, vibration, on or off, again for notifications. Help and feedback, tell them right there what you need help with, and then about, that's gonna be overall your account, so I'm not gonna go into that. And then we're gonna come back to our main homepage because that has been the application for the Tapo Pan Tilt Home Security Wi-Fi Camera. As you saw, there are a lot, and I mean a lot of things